The music world is in mourning tonight. R&B singer Teena Marie died in her sleep last night at the age of 54. Her career included multiple Grammy nominations and spans decades. Marie was booked to play Atlanta's Fox Theater next Saturday, and CNN's Don Lemon joins me now with his memories of the soul singer. Don, so what kind of legacy is Teena Marie leaving behind?
It's probably, Hala, good evening, by the way, it's probably a bigger one than most people realize. I've seen people saying, who is Teena Marie? But of course, it's going crazy on the social media. Teena Marie was really a woman. She was a white woman who sort of crossed over, not sort of crossed over, she crossed over into soul music very early on in the late 70s and early 80s. And of course, she was Rick James's protege, and everyone remembers Rick James, if not from the time that he was there, but definitely from the Dave Chappelle show and that skit that he did. But Teena Marie, it's so circuitous, Hala, when you talk about, we always say the news business is a small business. I would say the music business, the entertainment business, is probably a smaller one, because Teena Marie started out at Motown and worked with Berry Gordy and worked with Richard Rudolph, who was Minnie Riperton's husband. Richard Rudolph was a producer at Motown. And, you know, loving you is easy because you're beautiful. That was Minnie Riperton. And so she worked with Minnie Riperton and Maya Rudolph, who is on SNL, sang on one of Teena Marie's early albums. Maya was 7 years old, and so Maya's dad and her mom produced many of Minnie Riperton's first songs. And now Teena Marie's first song, and Teena Marie is actually Maya Rudolph's godmother.
Oh, so interesting.
She ushered in that. And then there's a song that you have. I think you have Lover Girl.
Lover Girl, yeah. Let's play that.
Let's listen to a little bit of it, and I'll tell you about that.
Okay. What's interesting is this is kind of a whole era there.
That's a whole era of rap. She actually helped to usher in the whole rap hip-hop era. That was from 1981, but 1984, that song. But 1980, 1981, she actually did Square Biz, which was one of the first rap songs ever that she rapped on. I remember her during this era. We waited and waited and waited in Louisiana at the fairgrounds for hours for her and for Rick James to show up. And they were late. It was hot in the summer. The fairgrounds were over capacity. And then I remember, and these are pictures you're looking at now from Jazz Fest when she played in New Orleans. She's a huge among people who liked R&B. So I remember waiting for her, and then when the helicopter flew her and Rick James in, and the crowd went crazy, and they were handing out water and pouring water on people. This was during the Fire and Desire era, and I don't know if you guys, if people who are listening remember, but us old heads, people who are in their 30s and 40s, remember Fire and Desire from both of them. Just amazing, amazing music, and the music industry is going to miss her. I talked to a long-time DJ, Herb Kent, who is in the Radio Hall of Fame when these reports started coming out, and one of them was from his radio station, WVAZ, in Chicago, and he said she was one of the best vocalists ever, one of the best people in the business. And actually, according to Troy Tyler, who's also a long-time DJ there, she started this act, created this initiative called the Brockert Initiative. Mm-hmm. She tried to get out of her contract with Motown, that eventually helped all members of the music profession, those who were under contract. If you were under contract with someone and they weren't releasing your music or paying you, this initiative allowed you to get out of that contract. So she allowed people, many people in the business, like Luther Vandross, among others, to be able to get out of their contract and make money by going to other publishing companies. A huge loss for the business.
All right, Don Lemon, great insight. I'm filling in for you tonight, so I think we're going to see you next weekend. Good talking to you there about Teena Marie, her death, very young, age 54, and her legacy as well.